Hey to you. I want to welcome you to another episode of How I Animate in Clip Studio Paint. Hey, welcome back to the channel. Today's topic is going to be my animation process, what I've learned so far. You can thank one of the viewers. So the total process is about 14 steps. So I'm gonna split it into two videos. So this one will be 7 steps. And all timestamps will be in the description below. So if you wanna get a clear understanding, you gotta stay all the way through the steps. So let's get straight into it. Step one is write a script. You wanna plan out your animation ahead of time, whether it's with the words that the characters are gonna say, the environment that the character is gonna be in, actually write out what the animation should be. Even if it's as simple as the character is walking through a door, you need to write that out. And if the character, all they do when they get inside the door is scream, you need to write that out also. I don't care how short it is, you should write it out and plan it ahead of time. See, I made this mistake when I was first doing my animations, and it took longer for me to complete an animation just because I didn't plan it out, because it was just pure chaos. So this helps shorten the full process of your animation getting done once you get started, so you don't make a bunch of mistakes. Now, during this process, what's gonna happen is you're gonna come up with backgrounds and stuff like that if you're using backgrounds. So in that process of writing your script, go ahead and get some references so you can get ready for your backgrounds and stuff like that. Nini Samahani. Oh, you're still here. I like that. You're serious about your animation, huh? Well, let's get straight into the next step. I like that about you. Yeah. Step two, design your characters. Whatever character, even if it's one character or if it's many characters, design your characters ahead of time. If you got a bunch of background characters, you don't have to do too much about that. It would help if you did have a design for all background characters, if you want to keep it simplistic, but design your main characters. That way it makes it easy when you're storyboarding and you're sketching out what you want your animations to do, and you have a good reference so you can kind of maintain some consistency in the look of your character. So design your characters, it helps a lot. Oh, and don't forget to use reference. If you need a template, like a turnaround template for your character design, so you can model your character off of that template, that's fine too. But don't forget to use reference. Step three, storyboarding. This includes using your backgrounds. So you wanna sketch out your backgrounds in your animations. Make sure that you're using these references that you got when you were putting together your script, or whatever character design you did, or whatever background you want to have the character in. And please keep it minimal. It's more like almost stop animation when you're doing storyboarding. You just want to emphasize with that sketch. Don't do all of the details. Just emphasize with that sketch what you want the audience to feel or see when that animation fully comes together, or what your vision was when you were writing the script in the first place. Step four, create an animatic. So to create an animatic, what you wanna do is record some basic audio of the words that you want your characters to say in the scene. You can use your phone, you don't need to do anything professional or anything like that. We just wanna get a feel of what your animation is gonna sound like and feel like when you combine the images and the audio together. So to create an animatic, you wanna take all of the pages of your storyboard and export them out. And when you export them out, you wanna bring them into whatever video editing program that you use. And in that video editing program, you wanna add the audio to it. So you can do Adobe Premiere, Sony Vegas, whatever. It doesn't matter. As long as you can bring in MP4s into the program, you can combine those two. Now, there may be a problem here. Maybe you don't have that stuff. So here's a list of a couple programs that you can use that are free that you can download. So Hit Film Express is one. That's free. Lightworks is another one that is free. And Movie Maker is something that you can download free. Now, I don't know the full details because I use Adobe Premiere. But you can download those things, for those programs for free, and do your video editing inside of there. Now, if you still do not want to leave Clip Studio Paint, to do the video editing, we have a problem. Because Debut and Pro is not designed for full animation. It's basically to wet your palette to animation. You're only doing that real full animation in EX. So if you have Debut and Pro, what you'll have to do is put together a bunch of different ones and watch them separately. So I suggest you to leave outside of Clip Studio Paint if you have those programs. But if you do have EX, you can bring in the videos that you made into Clip Studio and line them up back to back, just like another animation, and then bring in your audio also. So it's possible, but just not on the Pro level or the Debut level. Step 5, adjust your animatic. After you go over your animatic and look at it a few times, you're gonna see some things that you don't like and that you do like, or some things that you wanna enhance. So go back over your animatic, check through your sketches, and make notes of things that you wanna change and make that adjustment, and then come back to your animatic, like re-update your animatic, until you feel satisfied with what you're seeing and you feel like, okay, you're getting your point across with the animation that you're gonna create at the end. Step 6, flesh out your animations. This is where you start really finishing up those animations. And I'm not talking about inking, it's not the cleaning up part. We need to get real messy and start making those characters move. Let's complete those animations that you want those characters to do. So start fleshing out the animations, get rid of the background. We don't want to see the background. We're focused on the animation. Now, if you want the background to be slightly faded, bring the opacity down to the back of the background. And now you can see kind of like what your character is doing. Let's get real messy and let's get it done so that now we can move on to the next step. Step 7, test out your animations. I want you to test them out in the animatic. Update that animatic with these animations that you've done. Like I said, the background really shouldn't be there, but if you need it for a reference, that's fine too. But test out these animations that you put all of this work in, because once it's time to ink your animation, you don't wanna have to go back, at least not to the sketching part. So test them out, update that animatic until you're satisfied. Now this is the final step of this part of the video. If you wanna get to the next 7 steps, you're gonna have to go to the next video. I will put a link up once it's done that'll link this video to that video. But look, you are basically halfway done with your animation and the process. So this is my process. I hope that this helps you and you develop your own process if you wanna make some adjustments. But I think that's enough for this video. And as always, anime life forever.